The EP Podcast, heard everywhere podcasts can be found, and always at theeppodcast.com.
This week on the show, I know for sure we have an Eating Evergreen Park that's going to pop up here. We're trying out a brand new spot over on Western Avenue that I think everybody's going to enjoy. I tested it, and it was amazing. I'm bringing you and my wife, Erica, because she goes all these because she invented the Eating Evergreen Park segment.
Yes, she did.
She gets to go.
Yes, she did.
So the three of us are going over there. Everybody can hear that on this show. I have a problem.
And?
I have a little bit of condition I'm dealing with this week. I hope you will be understanding of it.
Okay.
You might have to take the lead, though. Remember we were joking and somebody walked up and said, oh, I listen to Hannah's show?
Yes, my show.
This may have to be Hannah's show in some part today.
You might have to help me.
I went to the doctor today, the day that we're recording the show.
Okay.
I went to like an ear, nose, and throat specialist because I was having a problem. I've noticed that when I'm doing the show the last couple of weeks, I hear myself straining while I'm talking.
Okay.
And I've been feeling like this pain in my neck. It turns out my vocal cords are like, I don't know, they're like guitar strings that need to be changed.
It's not the West Nile or anything
that we thought you had. No, we don't have any of those. Remember I told you I was worried about all these things?
Yes.
In the end, the neck pain and everything else came from a vocal cord injury.
Interesting.
So the only way they could fix it, like they're giving me steroids so I can get through these shows that I the shows that I have to do right now.
Yes.
But then they're like, and then stop speaking. So I'm not going to talk for like days.
That's funny.
Oh, and you know what the worst thing is that the children have already caught on to it. Like Erica made a joke like, I guess I'll win all the arguments. And she will because there's nothing I can do about it. But the kids, Hannah, they know. And what's frightening is they all understand that dad does not have the time to argue with them and can't argue with them. Like I came home today and I said, look, I'm going to try to talk not that much because I know that they're injured, but I got to do the show for this week. You know, I got to record this one here, the EP podcast. I had to finish up our Socks in the Basement that we're doing. I had to finish up. There's a lot of shows I could put out here at this basement bar, and EP podcast is just one of them, and they come out a week. I mean, I end up doing five different shows a week for five different podcasts. And I was like, I got to finish everything. So I don't want to talk very much until I get in front of the microphone with Hannah tonight. And it was like every 30 seconds, somebody had a question. The kids are arguing and they're doing things like, we can have ice cream, right? I mean, don't say anything if we can have ice cream.
It's now time for an EP Word on the Street. My name is Dominic Lanuti, and I'm filling in this week because the doctor told Dad he wasn't allowed to talk this weekend after straining his vocal cords, and this segment hadn't been recorded yet. Here we go. All Evergreen Park residents should have received their vehicle sticker applications in the mail by now. But since our post office is terrible, many people are saying they didn't get them yet. So the village is now saying you can download an application online, or you should probably get into the village hall or the currency exchange on 95th and Kedzie soon before long lines start showing up at these locations. Also, Dad wants me to tell you that he locked in village trustee Mark Mazzullo and the Evergreen Park School District 124 superintendent for next week's show. If you have any questions for either of these gentlemen, you can ask them in advance by calling 708-459-8406 and leaving a message. Call anytime, 708-459-8406. That's your EP Word on the Street, and Eating Evergreen Park is coming up. The EP Podcast is found everywhere podcasts can be found, and always at theeppodcast.com.
The Academy of Self-Defense and Fitness in Evergreen Park celebrates its 50th anniversary with an expansion and a party. Saturday, September 7th from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Owners Jeff and Pam Waldrum are inviting their neighbors, current members, friends, and anyone interested in martial arts and fitness to this 50th anniversary celebration. There's going to be free classes and martial arts activities and games, tickets to local mixed martial arts competitions, and a grand prize to become a member for 6 months on them. That's right, you could become a member of Team ASD. Members of Team ASD have included professional and amateur MMA competitors, people who employ self-defense skills in their professions, and your average student looking to train and learn a new skill set. If you've never seen it before, go check out the Academy of Self-Defense in Evergreen Park on either their 50th anniversary, September 7th, starting at 11 a.m., or anytime, 3753 West 95th Street in Evergreen Park. We'll see you there. Hannah, my wife Erica, is down here.
Yes,
and
she is.
That must mean we're doing an Eating Evergreen Park this week.
Yes!
All right, so we are going to go to American Dog and Burger. They are over in the plaza on the east side along Western Avenue. And we ran into them at, where was it, Day in the Park?
It was Day in the Park.
They were there. We met them, and we're going to go see the two owners, the guys who started the entire thing. They have more than one location, but this is their first foray into the South Side, and they picked Evergreen Park, and they open up an American Dog and Burger. We're going to meet both the brothers, so let's head on out right now and meet ADB, American Dog and Burger. This week on Eating Evergreen Park, we have traveled to the east side of Evergreen Park, and we're trying out the brand new American Dog and Burger. These guys here sitting with me, I am going to cross my fingers and hope I introduce them properly. We have the two brothers. We have George and Manoli Elpogiannis.
Perfectly said.
I got it.
Perfectly said, and thank you very much, Chris, because you actually had your fingers crossed as you were making that announcement. And you did great. It's been a long time since we've heard it pronounced properly.
I actually had to sit there and go over my head a few times with it before I hit the record button. All right, so you brought out this incredible spread. You guys do basically, you have hot dogs, you have burgers, and then you have sandwiches, wraps, a lot of chicken products and things like that that are here. And you know, with the name American Dog and Burger, you pretty much know what this is. But tell me the concept behind this and where it came from.
Well, the whole concept came from, of course, is we're third-generation restaurateurs, and our family was very, very big on road trips. And as, you know, the family, we got older, my brother and I started, you know, going on road trips together. And we noticed as we were driving around the country, different locations, that everybody either dressed or didn't dress a hot dog like we do here in Chicago. And we found it quite interesting. Whether we were directed to a condiment bar that had ketchup, mustard, and onion on it versus, you know, coleslaw being put on hot dogs in the South. And we were just really, really enthralled with the whole concept that, you know, because we're born and raised in Chicago. We knew Chicago hot dogs. There was never ketchup on a hot dog. And it was dragged through the garden, and so we had, you know, all the toppings on there. And we thought that it'd be neat to bring these different thoughts and ideas back to the city.
Just talking hot dogs, and we tried a lot of them today. You have the Chicago style, and then you have some named, I'm just going to give out the names here, the Baltimore, the Santa Fe, the Atlanta, the Dallas. You got a Maxwell Street, you got a Milwaukee. You got the Louisville, which I just love. There are some really interesting concepts here, but what's really neat about it is they're not just all in the same bun. Tell me a little bit about what goes into them, because you're using different sauces on different burgers. Everything has its own taste. Everything has its own bun that's specifically made for it. These are more gourmet than just somebody making a hot dog and then going down a line and grabbing, like, I got to get, this condiment, this thing here, and then move on to the next hot dog, right?
Yeah, well, what we felt was we wanted to build these flavor profiles for everybody here. And, you know, there are a lot of great hot dog stands throughout the Chicagoland area. You know, Chicago was all about their neighborhood hot dog stands, which, you know, in part brought us down here to Evergreen Park. But we thought that, you know, we wanted to show off, instead of having just the plain hot dog bun or the poppy seed bun, that we would, you know, build these profiles according to what ingredients are being used, you know, in these regions that we've named the dogs after.
Manoli, you you have some interesting sides as well, and the sauces. And you guys seem to really like ghost peppers too. But the thing that I liked about it was the fact that the ghost peppers didn't make me feel like I had to run out of the room screaming or just down my milkshake as quickly as possible. It's adventurous. You don't see this in very many places. Is that the intent to kind of bring something that people wouldn't see anywhere else?
Yeah, so we wanted to be unique. Like my brother said, there's tons of hot dog stands that are great. There's tons of places to grab a great burger. But really, we wanted to dial up the menu. And I personally love different types of sauces. I love cheese. And so, dipping your tater tots in chipotle aioli or taking your jalapeno, beer-battered jalapenos, and dipping them in a white cheddar sauce. Those are things that just kind of add on to the flavor a little bit, balancing, you know, if you're taking some beer-battered jalapenos and dipping it in a white cheddar sauce, it kind of cools the palate a little bit and adds another layer of flavor. So yeah, we definitely, you know, it was totally intentional, and we also kind of cater to what we like as well.
You guys have done several different restaurants in your lives, and you've worked in the restaurant industry. It's a family thing. Then you start American Dog and Burger, and you know this is your creation, but they're popping up in different spots. Very early on, though, you have one in Evergreen Park. Why Evergreen Park?
You know, Evergreen Park was totally intentional for part of our expansion. Look, it's a great community. It's family-centered. People that understand our food, people that have a healthy dining out scene in the Evergreen Park area. And it just kind of fit our demographic. When you think about where we have stores, Navy Pier and O'Hare, there's a lot of families that are traveling through there. It's not like it's the nightclub scene that where we currently have stores. So you could easily see our customers at Navy Pier living in the Evergreen Park area. It just spoke to us.
What would you say, don't come to American Dog and Burger without trying this?
You know, the Chicago-style hot dog, of course, is our staple. The Louisville, one of my favorites. I love everything about it. And it's a meal in its own. Nice side dish with it. But we have a nice array of things that will satisfy everyone's needs here, from, you know, our two different styles of chicken salads, as well as, you know, any of the sides that you can mix and match to sort of fill in that area. You know, meals for the kids, and, you know, for God's sakes, you got to have a milkshake to wash it all down.
Yeah, I like the idea that I could get all the flavors, like, stacked. Was that just because I was special, or could somebody else walk in and ask for that?
Well, you are very special, Chris. But we do want everyone to feel that special, too. So, yeah, if you ask them for a stacked or a layered milkshake, they can get vanilla, chocolate, strawberry, as well as banana, which is my favorite.
Yeah, I liked them all mixed together, too, when I was trying this out. Okay, Manoli, what do they get when they come in here?
Hey, look, if you love burgers, you've got to try the bacon cheddar burger. It's a hardwood smoked bacon, cooked fresh with a certified black Angus patty. It's a third of a pound. It's on a brioche bun. The cheddar cheese is, you know, outstanding, and the real key to that burger is the AD&B sauce. That secret sauce is really, my brother put it together. I love it. It's a burger that I eat. And a lot like my brother, I eat the Louisville dog all the time. You know, that pretzel roll really, you know, that's what people want. That's now a standard. So I love that. And every now and then when I feel a little guilty, I'll have the chicken pita. So the chicken pita, you know, it's to our Greek heritage. It's, you know, marinated in different herbs and spices. And then we put it in a pita with some tzatziki sauce on the side. It's a little bit lighter, but it's definitely filling.
You know, and I'm a little bit of a snob when it comes to burgers and hot dogs. I really like a burger and a dog with good bread. Nothing's like getting a really nice burger and the bread just falls apart. You have this nice brioche bread on the burgers. And I like with the hot dogs, like you say, you didn't just put everything in a poppy seed bun. You know, you have the toasted brioche, which, you know, like you said, it's a nod to New England with the lobster rolls, and then there's the pretzel roll for the hot dog. So none of it's cookie cutter by any means, and that's what I really like about it.
And I think that I'm going to have to roll myself out of here after trying all the food that you guys gave me, but it was incredible. Once again, we have George and Manoli Alpogianis.
Hey, that's perfect. You got it. Yeah. There you go.
An American Dog and Burger. Come see them. They're at 9646 Southwestern. And tell them you heard them on the EP podcast. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Chris.
Thanks. Thanks for having
Anna,
us.
Anna, Erica, thanks for joining
thank you.
As well.
Thank you for
we appreciate
us.
All
thank you.
Having you guys here at the table with us.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, I'm full.
Yeah.
I mean,
so
like, we go do these things and people bring out stuff for us to try. And every once in a while, we'll run into a restaurant owner that just wants me to try everything on the menu.
This was
and
it.
These guys wanted you to try everything on the menu. And you know what? It was all good. That was the thing. Like,
yes.
I mean, like, you could pick things that you like and things that you don't really have. Like, I've never been a Chicago-style hot dog guy. See what I'm saying? Like, I'll eat one every once in a while, but I'm just a guy who just likes to put mustard on his dog. And I when I have, like, one with a poppy seed, that's all I do. But I did try their Chicago style, and it was good.
It was
I've
really
had other
good.
Chicago styles, and that one was really good.
I normally put ketchup on it, too, but it was good.
Yeah, well, you're not from Chicago originally, and that's why you do that.
You get a hall
okay?
pass.
You get a hall pass, okay? It was good. I'm full.
Part
of me thinks that Evergreen Park might have a new champion of hot dogs.
Oh, definitely.
There's a few
fancy hot dogs.
There's a few spots here, but I mean, like, you go there, it's a meal.
Gourmet hot dogs.
You go have that hot dog, that's a meal. I like the guys, too. You know? I like the two guys that are running the place.
Yeah, you can tell they're like a family business.
Really
you know?
Nice family guys. You two girls could not stop looking at Manoli.
Manoli cannoli.
You guys liked Manoli, huh? What was it that Erica said when she got into the car? My wife? What was the first thing she said when she shut the door? What was the first thing you said?
I said that he was a gorgeous
He's
man.
He's a gorgeous man. Manoli's
pretty.
A gorgeous man. That's what my wife said.
Part.
No, it's going up there, okay? I want proof you were checking out the guy from American Dog and Burger with your husband sitting next to you, okay? But no, I mean, they're nice guys. You know, they get the family guys. You talk to them. They got, you know.
Super
they got,
friendly.
They got families. They're friendly. They, you know, they fit in real well with Evergreen Park. And I think that you understood that they kind of picked that location and they picked this area because they liked the people from this area and they liked the feel of this area.
They love the mayor.
They love working in Evergreen. They love having a business in Evergreen. They really talked a lot about that before we even started the interview, that they really like being in Evergreen. It's not just that location because it's like edge of Evergreen and you got the Beverly people too and that's where they're at. They actually really like being a part of Evergreen. You know, they're not on Western Avenue just to be like the Western Avenue thing. You could tell they like Evergreen Park. That was cool.
I think that's the reason why you saw them at Day in the Park, too, is because they like Evergreen. So they wanted to be a part of that.
Yeah, they really kind of feel like that. They're a part of it and they really kind of want to be a part of it. So that was really good. OK, so let's talk about our favorite stuff that we had there. What did we like? What did you really like besides the gorgeous Greek man that sat across from you, Erica?
I really liked the A&D burger. Their special sauce on that burger was wonderful. If I had to pick a hot dog, I was into the Santa Fe.
What's on the Santa Fe?
The Santa Fe.
Because we're saying these names, we did it during the interview, but I didn't want to get into everything that's on these. But they're all like these very unique things. I mean, like, it's a culinary hot dog. Is what this is.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So what's on the Santa Fe?
The Santa Fe is hardwood smoked bacon, chipotle, aioli, which I...
Mayo.
caramelized onions, beer-battered jalapeno caps, and cojita cheese on a Texas toast roll.
Yeah. That was good. And that's another thing that they do is that they have... everything has a different bread, let's say.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm, depending on what they're making, there's a different bread for it. It's not the same type of bun.
You're not
going to
get a
really
poppy
neat.
Seed bun on all your hot
yeah,
dogs.
Yeah, that was kind of neat. Okay. So then, Hannah, what was your favorite when you were over? What did you like the best about
that? Oh, the Louisville hot dog.
You know, when you're eating it, you feel like you might not make it through the dog.
And that would be just fine.
And
that would
like,
be a good last
gonna
meal
die,
to
if
have.
I'm going to die because I ate this. Right.
Yes.
But it's
if
good.
That would be my last meal, yeah. I would have died happy.
What's on that again?
It's really good. Okay, number one, it's on a pretzel roll. So that's a winner for me. But it was a deep fried hot dog. It's smoked cheddar cheese sauce. There's maple bourbon bacon and onion strings. So you get the smoky sweetness, but everything is gooey and
Now, I want you to read off what was on the Baltimore for me, because you got the menu in front of you. What's on the Baltimore?
Baltimore was good, too. They got this. Number one, when you go there, the Chipotle aioli. You want to dip your french fries in that.
Yeah, get that sauce on the side.
Just get that sauce.
Just get that sauce on the side.
Or tater tots.
Or your tater tots or whatever you're going to get. They even do jalapeno, breaded jalapeno chips.
Yeah.
You can put that in the aioli.
You want the Chipotle aioli. Okay, the Baltimore dog.
Yeah.
It's another deep fried hot dog. It has ghost pepper cheese. Don't let that scare you. Ghost pepper cheese, fried onion strings, and Chipotle aioli on a Texas toast roll.
Yeah, that was my favorite. That was, yeah. I had that and I really, really
it
liked
was the,
that
the,
one.
The bread is like I said, it's like a Texas toast, but it's nice and buttery too. Yeah. There's flavor to it. It's not just bread.
Yeah. Like, I really like that one. And then the other thing that I really liked, and you could tell when you were in there, is how fresh the food was.
Mm-hmm.
So like they brought out like one of their salads. They had like a really nice salad. What was that one? It's their big one that they had
it's,
there.
It's the chopped chicken salad.
Yeah. Okay. So you could tell that, you could see them cooking. They take a piece of chicken. And they cook a piece of chicken. They're not taking out a frozen piece of chicken. They're not, you know, I mean, you get that impression whenever you see a place that's in a strip mall or that, you know, is over in that area, like in the Plaza or something like that. You might be worried that this is like, okay, this is like a chain restaurant or whatever. It's really not. That's the thing. They were talking
to us.
It's a local chain. They own it.
Yes.
And they've just started the idea of possibly, you're just starting to let people franchise it.
Right.
But this is one of their stores.
Okay.
And they've been doing this now for years. So it's like these guys are like the creators and this is their store. So and they're just like starting to talk to people about the idea of like going to other places in the Chicagoland area. We're fortunate enough that they decided to open one here because it was like Navy Pier and they got one at O'Hare.
Right.
And then they're like, and now we're going to do Evergreen Park. I mean, think about that. First of all, I think they're the kings of hot dogs right now in Evergreen Park.
Oh, definitely.
Which and I never thought that I would say that. Okay. I mean, there's other places around here that do dogs and do different size and do weird, interesting things. But this is really good stuff. And they're the kings right now, I would say, until somebody could prove me otherwise. And then they make a great burger. So I'm hard pressed, you know, I mean, there's other places that make burgers, but I mean, for that price, that's a good spot. If you want to stop in and get a burger for lunch or something like that, or get burgers for the family and bring them home or go to the restaurant and actually sit down and eat them. It's just it's a good spot run by good people who clearly want to be part of Evergreen. So I'm all for them. And I think people should go over there and check them out.
I definitely think they should check it out. And I'm looking forward to, like, if my family comes into town and taking them over there, I think that they would like this a little bit. This is different, you know?
Well, I think the fun thing about it is that if you had people come in from out of town and they're like, I want to eat Chicago food, you could bring them there and get them a Chicago-style hot dog, but you could also bring them there and show them the different things they do with hot dogs. And I think that's something that Chicago has always been known for, is that they do hot dogs.
Right.
You know, when I moved to where you're from in Wheeling, West Virginia, when we met, I would ask people, where do I get a good dog? And they'd look at me like I was nuts because people don't do that in very many places. So, I mean, this would be the kind of place you bring them to and be like, check this out. I mean, like, seriously, would you bring them to Portillo's or would you bring them to this place?
We would go here.
It'd be a great date night too, you know?
Oh my God, please don't look at me like you want to go back so you can oogle at the guy that runs the place while I get fatter eating all the food. The world is fast and busy. Sometimes you got to get down to your speed. And the place to lower your speed and relax in Evergreen Park is at the Red Palm. Maybe your speed is wine on a Wednesday with your friends for Wine Down Wednesday. Maybe turtle races and Queen of Hearts on Thursday nights is more your speed. Each and every night, though, at the Red Palm, you get a little island attitude at a local latitude. When you walk into the Red Palm, it's like walking into an island bar, but right in Evergreen Park. With a menu like no other created by Chef Mario and cooked in a beautiful wood fire oven. Unique taste, comfort foods, and honestly, the best wings you're gonna find anywhere. Have a tropical drink, a craft beer, a glass of wine, or share a bucket of lights with your friends. Watch the game on one of the many flat screen TVs over the top of their bar or out on the patio. Get out this summer. The Red Palm at 3020 West 95th Street. Island attitude, local latitude. A couple of things here I want to tell you about. There is a big contest now available on the EP podcast for listeners of the EP podcast from the Broadcast Basement On Demand Radio Network. It is finally set, and it is happening on Friday, the 20th of September.
Okay.
From 3 p.m. until 10 p.m.
Okay.
The Ileana Brew Bus, partnering with the Broadcast Basement On Demand Radio Network, which includes the EP podcast, to bring you a complete 7 brewery tour of the Dixie Highway Brewery Trail. Starting at Horse Thief Hollow at 3 p.m., we will be at Blue Island Beer Company for those that have to work. Let's say you can't get out early because it's a Friday.
Right, that would be
But they told
me
there's no way they can do all 7 of them unless we started at 3.
Okay.
And I want to do all 7.
Yes.
So we won't leave the Blue Island Beer Company until like 5:30, 5:45.
Okay,
good. So if you're coming and you can't make it to the first 2, you can join us in Blue Island and get on the bus. I got a parking lot there.
That's good.
We'll get you back to your car. See what I'm saying?
I see what you're saying.
So so there's two spots for you to jump on. You could jump on at the original spot when we first kick off at Horse Thief. You could probably find your way onto the bus over at Open Outcry, which is spot number 2. Blue Island Beer Company, spot number 3. The other 4, we head further south until we get to Crete, Illinois, and get a ride back with the Ileana Brew Bus. This is how, Hannah, you get on the bus.
Tell me.
Okay.
I'm excited to see who's going to be on the bus with us.
I know. It could be anybody. Here's how this works. We're going to do this 2 different ways. You could be selected, A, by me finding your EP podcast car magnet. That could happen.
Put your magnet on your car.
But this is how every other show on the Broadcast Basement Network is doing it. So this is probably how you're going to get on. What you need to do is follow us on either Facebook, the EP Podcast, Twitter, at the EP Pod, or Instagram, at the EP Pod. After you followed us on one of those 3 social media sites, and if you've already followed us, you're already done with step 1. Step 2 is, whatever podcast player you use, including at the eppodcast.com, which is Podbean runs that one, you can leave a comment and rate the show. Rate and comment on the show. Now, I think the best place to do this is on Apple Podcasts. So if you listen on Apple Podcasts, it's great. But we will see any comment. I get an email notification whenever anybody on anything rates and comments on the show. So give me a rating and comment, like 5 stars, you guys rock. Just anything like that. Just one little rating and comment. That's all I'm asking for. That enters you in. And the third thing is, then share at least 1 episode of the show. All you have to do is when I post the episodes on the pages or on the Twitter or whatever like that, just share it. Share it on your social media account. That's it.
Just hit the button.
1, 2, 3.
You don't have to make a fancy post.
Right. If for some reason your handle, let's say on Facebook or your Twitter or Instagram, is different from the handle that you used when you reviewed the show, just take a screenshot of it. Or send me a message through one of those social media things. You can message us privately on all those things. And just tell me, I'm so-and-so. It came up when I did the review under this name. I want to be in the contest. And I'm going to pick from those people and put them on the bus. So that's how you'll get entered. I will create a list off of this. So it's listen, subscribe, share.
Boom.
Boom. You're on. Listen, subscribe, and share. And you could be on the first ever EP Podcast, Broadcast Basement Network, Dixie Highway Brewery Trail Beer Tour.
Now, will they be joining listeners from the other podcasts?
There will be listeners from the other
podcasts.
That's
great.
So the Sox podcast, they have a chance. The Broadcast Basement podcast has a chance.
Nice.
I don't think we're going to get anybody from Me and the Priest, the Catholic one with Father Paul. Father Paul wants to go on it, but I mean, I don't know if we're going to get anybody to watch. But
you
know, who knows? Maybe we'll get somebody on the priest show. You know, we'll get some drunken Catholics that are going to want to be on the show. I have no idea. Okay. That's how you do it. Make sure it starts right now. You never know when I'm going to start drawing names. It starts right now. Listen, subscribe, and share. And we're going to see you on the 20th of September. It's the greatest week of the year, Hannah. Ask me why.
Of the whole year?
Of the whole year.
Out of everything.
It is the greatest week of the year.
Now, I don't know if it's August.
I don't know if it's the greatest week of the year for everybody in Evergreen Park. For me and my wife, it is the greatest week of the year.
What is going on in the middle of August that I don't know about?
You don't know? You can't guess this? It has to do with my children.
You're so excited to send those poor kids back to school.
Oh my God, they're getting out of my house. This is the greatest thing ever.
They have to put their uniforms back on. Oh, they have to
wonderful.
Sit at a desk.
We've already done uniform try-on.
They have to listen to a teacher
we
talk all
day. We picked up our
day.
Packets.
Sit in a wooden chair.
It's great. They all got their teacher assignments.
They got their packets.
And they're going back to school. Like, I'm throwing them out of my house, and the four-year-old goes 5 days a week now.
All
only
day?
For a half day.
Oh,
but
half
it's
day.
5 days a week where I get 3 hours of peace a day for 5 days in the week. Do you know how amazing that is? I don't know what I'm going to do. I know I'm going to start off the first week just sitting around in my underwear from 8 o'clock in the morning till 11 when I have to get him.
Yeah.
Watching, like, wrestling on WWE Network.
Yes.
Or just, you know, vegging out in front of like an old television show. But eventually I'm going to find a way to use that time to, like, you know, exercise or...
No, you won't.
No, I won't.
No, you won't.
But, you know, I mean, like, I'm just, it's incredible. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. I want them to do things. Like, they go over to Most Holy Redeemer. So they're back to school this week. Okay. The oldest is going into eighth grade. It's going to be class of 2020 now for the next, like, 6 months or so.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what to... All I know is that it's like an event every week over there. And there's just... Like, she's got to dance.
Was
it she's
like that when you were in eighth grade?
She's going to a dance tonight. That's the other thing. She's going to her first dance. They're having a thing. This comes out on Monday. So they're having a thing tonight over there for the eighth grade kids. She's going to her first dance.
Okay.
We had to get a dress.
Well, yeah.
There's going to be a hairstyling. And
oh.
It says casual. It says dress casual. But her and all of her friends are like sending text messages like, did you get a dress? What do you do with your hair? And I'm like, these boys don't even, like, none of them are going to pay attention. You know, you don't have the heart to tell her that.
Yeah.
But I remember eighth grade dances. They're all going to stand over in the corner and look uncomfortable. That's what they do.
But
I can't
girls,
imagine it's any different now.
Are the girls really dressing up to impress the boys, or are they trying to impress one another?
I think it's a little
who's
from column A and a little from column B. I mean, what were you like
style?
In the eighth grade? Were you trying to impress the boys, each other, or both?
Each other.
But not the boys in any way.
Well,
because
you gotta remember, I was related to half of them.
These girls talk about boys.
Yeah.
I know that there's a Hollywood star, and I don't want to, I don't want to make my daughter uncomfortable, but I know that one of the many Marvel comic book heroes, the guy who plays him, she's got an absolute crush on.
Okay.
Where, like, when I pick up her phone and check her search history, it's just his name.
Wow.
Like, in many different variations.
But there's no boys at Redeemer that look like him, so...
No.
No.
No, not at all. There's no...
So,
there's no, there's
what
no
is
boys,
she worried about?
There's no boys that look like this guy anywhere, so don't worry about it.
Another show is wrapped up. Another show's in the books. Another show is wrapped up. And then by the looks, it's gonna be a good one. And we'll see you next week. And the nudies, baby. Another show is wrapped up, another show is wrapped up, another show is wrapped up, and it's in the books. Another show is wrapped up, another show is wrapped up, and by the looks, it's gonna be a good one. Nudie's Basement, Broadcast Basement, the Nudie's Basement, the Broad Basement.
Slancha.
Wait, no, the slow dances would be that awkward slow dance where your fingertips are barely touching.
What kind of slow dances were you doing in those grades? Was it like old time slow dances?
It was like Boys to Men. And
oh,
whatever
okay.
The slow jams were right, in the early all right. 90s.
All right. I danced to, what was the dance? I got to remember the dance. This will date me. This is best. It was Bon Jovi. I'll Be There For You.
Okay.
That's an awesome one, right? For
yeah.
First dance ever, Bon Jovi, I'll Be There For You.
Were you there for her?
I was singing it. That probably made it worse.
The EP Podcast. Heard everywhere podcasts can be found. And always at theeppodcast.com.
We all know that summer is here. And for many people, that means it's time to get the car ready for a long road trip. And now that we have GPS on our smartphones and in our cars, it's a lot easier to navigate these drives without getting lost. During your life and mine, you're going to take a lot of journeys. And one of those journeys is something that I am personally not very good at mapping out on my own. It's the road to your financial goals. But there's actually a financial goal GPS that you can use to help get you where you want to go. For people here in Evergreen Park, the GPS has a name, Tom Walsh. of Edward Jones, located right on the corner of 111th and Kedzie. The same things that your GPS does for you on these trips, Tom's going to help you with your financial plan. Listen, families in South Chicagoland have been benefiting from Tom's get-to-know-you approach and do-the-right-thing values for over 18 years. Contact my close personal friend, and also a fellow Brother Rice alumni, Tom Walsh. He's your local Edward Jones advisor, located in Mount Greenwood, right outside of the EP, at 111th and Kedzie. Member SIPC.